Hi, all. Blair Sable, investigative reporter here at Live 5 News. We have a story running tonight about a contractor who left customers out thousands of dollars. And I wish it was a different scenario, but we have done many stories like this one. So in doing these types of stories, I wanted to share with you tips and resources that you can use if you happen to be hiring a contractor anytime soon, but also if maybe down the line you are and you want to come back to this webpage, you can learn a little bit more and review what you should know before you hire a contractor. So first things first, you always want to ask them what their license, bond, and insurance is like. The first two are required by law, and you can ask the company to present you those documents, or you can also verify it for yourself through the South Carolina Department of Labor Licensing and Regulation. So we're going to head over to that website, and I'll show you how to look up that information. So here we are at LLRSC.gov, and you can see on their front page they have several links. We're going to go to look up a license. And you can see here, there's a drop-down menu. There are several things on this list, but in our particular case, we're talking about contractors who are working on your home. So you're gonna go down to residential builders right here. It's close to the bottom. We'll click that and select. So licenses have to be held by individuals. So generally speaking, that's gonna be the owner of the company or someone who works for the company. You can search by company name. So I'll use the example of the story that I'm working on today. So that is on the level. Let's see, okay, we got a few. Specifically the one that we are looking for, I believe. Actually, it's interesting. I searched this. Yes, here we go. Okay, so this is the owner of this particular business that we're looking into. So you can see they have an active license. You can see when it expires, what type it is, when it was first issued. You can also see what they specifically are allowed to do. So in this case, this contractor was only allowed to do carpentry and floor covering work. So you want to pay particular attention to that. If you happen to be doing another type of job, you want to make sure that they're licensed for that job. You can also see underneath here, bond on file expires 4/17/2022. So bonds are required by law if the project crosses a certain threshold. So in this particular case, he has a specialty license. So if he was doing a job more than $5,000, he would have to have an active bond on file. If he was a residential builder, for example, they always have to have a bond on file, and it always has to be more than $15,000. So this is a great resource to use. That should be your bare minimum. I also want to go back to that screen. Insurance, I mentioned that licensing and bonding is required by law in certain cases for the bond. Insurance is not required by law, but the Better Business Bureau says you should always check that your contractor is insured, because if there's something that happens in your home, on the job site, you might be held liable. So you should always ask the company if they can show you documentation of that. And you can also call the insurance company up yourself and asked to see that as well. So moving on here, we also have some information from the South Carolina Department of Consumer Affairs. So they always recommend that you have references when you hire a contractor, whether that be coming from a friend, family, coworkers. They also recommend that you should have at least two other bids from other companies to do the same kind of work. At the end of the day, you should always trust your gut. If something feels wrong, they recommend that you do business elsewhere. And also, you would want to check former complaints. So you can do that by searching the name of the business, the owner of the business, and scam or complaint. You can also head over to the Department of Consumer Affairs website, and that'll show you some information if someone has gone to the website. And I'm going to click on that right now. Okay, so here we are. We are at consumer.sc.gov. There's lots of information here as well. We're going to scroll down on the homepage and click search for complaints. And you know, this doesn't just go for any contractor you're hiring. You can also search pretty much any business that you work for. Any business that you deal with. Maybe you're interested in seeing if other people have had a similar issue, or if you're wary about working with them. This is a good resource for you to use. So like I said, these are some great resources to use. We have even more information on our website, live5news.com, from the Better Business Bureau as well. Even if you have a problem and you want to file a complaint, whether with LLR or the Department of Consumer Affairs, we also have information on how you can do that. And as always, make sure that you are doing your homework before you hire anyone to do work on your home.